evening, and welcome to the 13th annual Spooky Music. I am so glad that you have joined us for our very first ever virtual Spooky Music. And I say it like that because this is spookier than ever. Because we're not all gathered together in the same room, but we're scattered all over. And maybe you're even watching in the dark. Now, if you are new to Prince of Peace and our Hallow's Eve or Halloween traditions, you might be wondering, what is spooky music anyway? Well, it began 13 years ago with an organ concert of music that was scary and spooky for the season. And it has grown into a great celebration where we dress up in costumes. I am so glad to see so many of you in costume tonight. And we do other fun things too. Why are you looking at me so funny? Oh, I know, you were looking for Witch Hazel, not a witch named Sassy Susie. Well, Witch Hazel didn't know if she was able to come this year, but I have just heard from her that she will be with us tonight. She just couldn't be here in my living room. Just like I couldn't be there in yours. I'd like you to meet my cat, Milo. He's gonna dress up as a black cat for Halloween, or maybe a black and white cat. Anyway, Witch Hazel will be with us soon. But first, to get us into a spooky mood, let's listen to some music from our very own organist, Abe Hunter. This is Funeral March of a Marionette.
I am so delighted to see you. I didn't think I would be able to be with you on this spooky music night. Oh my goodness, it's so strange, isn't it? We're all in our houses and Halloween's coming and people are getting their costumes and their stories, often scary things, aren't they? I remember some of the stories. I was just looking at them, remembering some. There was one story I read you about the little old lady who was not afraid of anything until things were following her when she was out in the woods. She heard sounds, shoes clomping and hands clapping, and she heard wiggle, wiggle, and all of these things, and she ran to her house, but she said, I am not afraid of anything. And then she heard a knock at the door, and she opened it up, and there they were, all of those things standing at her door, and she said, I'm not afraid of anything, and she whispered to them. And then, remember, the next morning she lifted her shade in her bedroom, and there they had all gotten together and made themselves into a scarecrow. So she wasn't scared at all. Oh, that was a delightful story. I remember I enjoyed. Oh, and then there was this one. There was an, always old ladies, yes. There was an old lady who swallowed a bat. Imagine that. Ooh, she swallowed many things. I don't think we'll go into that one anymore. No. Oh. Then there was the one about the child, the little boy. And he started out with saying, sometimes I'm scared. When, oh, remember this one. Sometimes I'm scared of what's under my bed. Oh, look at all those things, yes. But then he would say, I am not scared once I clean everything out and I find all of my toys that were under the bed. Oh, yes, Halloween, scary things. Oh, and there was one other one I remember he said. Sometimes I'm scared on my first day of school. Oh, look at his face. So school. School is so different for you this year. Oh, it's so, I'm sure there are many frightening things or strange things, but remember, I'm not scared when I make new friends. Oh, and you'll be able to do that, yes. And you are doing that. I know you are doing that. And, oh, I think my favorite one that I read to you, perhaps, was What Was I Scared Of? By Dr. Seuss. Remember that one? Oh, yes, you do. I know you do. There was this little critter, and he was out in the woods, and all of a sudden, he saw something in the distance, and it was a pair of pale green pants. And, oh, it frightened him so much, he ran one way, and the pants went another way, and pretty soon the pants were in a boat, and they were in the river going somewhere, and he ran another place, and then they came by on a bicycle, and oh my goodness, pants one way, this little guy went the other way, and then he was hiding in a snide bush, and he looked out, and there they were, right in front of him, and they both got so frightened, they ran away, and the pants were whimpering and crying too, and suddenly they realized maybe they should just sit down together because they were no need to be afraid of each other. They were could be friends, even though they looked different. Oh, yes. Halloween, scary things, scary stories. But we do say, don't we, Happy Halloween. And so as I was remembering you tonight, I thought, well, I'm sitting here in my love seat with all of my happy memories right beside me. Yes, happy memories of, oh, this one. I have a dear friend who lives a long ways away, and she mailed this to me, sent it to me, and it has little fish all over it, my mask to wear so I don't get sick, so I don't make other people sick. Oh, and then Susie Q. Oh, Susie Q, a dear, dear young lady. She loved to dance and sing and play music. And she was a teacher of children. And she had this little flower she would sit in the window. And as the sun would shine on it, it would dance. Oh, and it is a happy memory that reminds me of dear Susie Q. Oh, and then this. Oh, one time, Witch Hazel was sick and in the hospital, but she came home and she got better. But two young lads is another word for little boys, but they came over and they brought her one thing, this little bear with wings. I call it my angel bear. And then how many of you remember Snuffleupagus with a big long nose? This other little lad loves Snuffleupagus, and they gave them to me. And so they're my very, very happy memories. Oh, I get choked up thinking about it. Oh, and then this. Oh, I had a gentleman friend who brought this to me because he loved birds, bird books. And, oh, yes. And I love cardinals. So he gave me this little statue. So another memory I have. And then, oh, this too. My jingle jangle necklace. Some children in school made this for me out of buttons and bells. Isn't it delightful? I haven't been able to show you this before. But then this last year, after spooky music was all done, in the mail came this card, and it said, "Thank you for doing spooky music. We had so much fun." Oh, and happy memories. I hear you have been doing things like that. You have been sending cards, and you have been making cookies, and you've been giving food, and you've been drawing chalk pictures and other pictures and sending cards, and, tying blankets, I've heard. Oh, you've been doing amazing things. You've been making memories. Yes, happy memories. I have an idea. This Halloween, a new idea. Things will be different anyway. So, why don't you have an adventure hunt, a treasure hunt for happy memories that you may have all around your homes? Salagadoola, metricaboola, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Pull them together and what have you got? Bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Good night, happy spooky music night, and happy Halloween memories.
Well, we are going to ask that very question in this next skit that our Pop Rocks youth put together for us. Hang on to your pumpkins. They might want them.
Man, I hate Halloween.
Yeah, me too.
Why? What's the matter with Halloween?
Oh, we should tell her. First, they cut off your vine.
Yeah, and then they cut your heads open.
And pull out your guts.
Then they cut you up with a saw.
Or a knife.
Or a drill.
Then they put a candle in you and light you up.
And leave you on the porch to rot for months.
No way. How do we get out of it?
I have an idea. All we have to do is be ugly pumpkins, and then nobody will pick us.
Okay.
Oh, shh. Someone's coming. Be ugly.
These pumpkins are way too ugly for Halloween. I'm gonna go look somewhere else.
That was close. Oh, man.
Wait, that would be perfect for pumpkin pie.
Oh, no!
No!
That story got me thinking about pumpkins and costumes and candy and ghosts and all these Halloween traditions. I wonder where they came from. I think I'll ask my friends on the Prince of Peace staff to help with that question.
'Twas the night before All Hallows' Eve, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The costumes were hung on hangers with care, in hopes that the big day soon would be there.
The children were nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of candy danced in their heads. But I lay awake in my bed, while thoughts and wonderings filled my head.
Where did Halloween come from, I muse, with its witches and ghosts and goblins shouting boo? Halloween means All Hallows' Eve, and hallowed means holy, I believe.
In the year 730, Pope Gregory said, we will have a day to honor the faithful who are now dead. He called it All Hallows' Day, but now All Saints' Day is what we say.
But wait, there is more. In the Middle Ages, people went door to door, dressed in disguises, begging for food to eat. That is where we get the idea of trick or treat.
In Spain, they celebrate as the church bells ring. A host of memories they do bring. In Poland, they walk in the woods to pray. From Scotland, we get the name of Halloween Day.
But what is spooky music, you ask? Fast forward a few years and grab your Halloween mask. It started as an organ concert with music that is spooky. And now we wear costumes you might find kooky.
This year, as we go online to celebrate, let's make this Halloween especially great.
I am so sad. It is almost time for spooky music to come to an end. I have loved having you here tonight. Thank you for coming. And as we often do, we would like to end by talking about All Saints' Day. That is when we light candles to remember people we love who have died. Let us end tonight with For All the Saints and lighting some candles. Thank you very much for joining us this evening.